on, guys? Welcome back to another video. My name is Ron and this is MotorTube. If you're stopping by for the first time, smash the subscribe button, turn your notification bell on to stay up to date with the videos, and be part of the family. If you're not already, follow me on Instagram. Make sure you go ahead and follow me at ToxicSRT. Also, add me on Snapchat at ToxicSRT as well. And as you can tell, I'm pretty tired right now. I had a long night last night and I was making videos and I barely got enough sleep. I'm up right now to go do a review. So we're about to hop in the Ram and get going. This is a pretty cool car that I always wanted to drive, always wanted to get my hands on and never really had the chance to. So we're gonna go ahead and get it done today. So let's hop in the truck and get going and let's have an awesome video. Let's get it. All right, guys, so we got the ZL1 right behind me and we're gonna get right into it. You guys know how I like to review cars. I don't tell you that Camaro was started in 1970s or whatever. I just show you guys what it is. We take it out for a drive and we see how fast it is and how it handles and what it looks like from inside and out. So let's get right into it. So these are the keys. Nothing too crazy, so let's get right into it. So this color is, it's silver obviously. And let's look at the wheels. Look at the wheels though. Look how sophisticated they look. These are probably my favorite wheels on a stock car. I think they're better than the Mustang wheels, the Hellcat wheels. They look best. Look at them. And then you got the Brembos, 6-piston Brembo brakes. And then I'm not sure, I don't think this is carbon fiber, but it goes all the way back. Little side skirt. Looks good. It would look good if it was in carbon fiber. And then you also got the lip here. This is the front end. It's pretty aggressive. And it actually looks really good in this color. Let's unlock it. And you got these LED strips right here. Looks pretty aggressive. And then look at this. This is all carbon fiber. And then it says ZL1 over here. And also, look at this. All these little holes right here, which I'm pretty sure they're for better airflow. All through here, all right there. Look, you can literally put the camera in there. And then it's all over here too, even the Chevy sign. So let's move to this side. The stance honestly looks really nice, honestly, and I'm not really a Chevy guy. Here under the hood, we got a 6.2 liter V8 pushing 650. Horsepower, so nothing crazy. That's the supercharger, the LT4. Got your intake right here. Yep, nothing too crazy. So here in the back, you got the ZL1 right there. You got the clear taillights. I don't know if that's what comes with it. It also has two tips on each side. And actually, let's turn it on while we're at it. So we're gonna do this. Or actually, lock it. Or might want to hold it then. Actually. How do you turn it on? That's weird.
2 hours later.
So let's give it a little start. We're gonna lock it twice and then hold this. The stock exhaust is pretty loud. Show you. That's a nice little idle. Put it in like track mode and try that. So we're pretty much done with the outside. Let's step inside and check the interior out. So we're gonna unlock it. All right, look at this. The cool thing about this is it has Alcantara literally everywhere. So you got Alcantara all over here with red stitching, of course. You got some plastic over here, but then we're back here with Alcantara. Alcantara here, Alcantara over here. Then the way you open the door is kind of weird. I haven't really seen it. Most cars, it's usually over here. With this one, it's up here. You have your memory seats, lock, unlock, your trunk. And then here, it says Camaro right here. And then the interior is just beautiful. I don't even know where to start with the interior because it's so nice. So we're gonna start out with the seats first. It has the Recaro seats with leather and suede right here, and also the red stitching everywhere. Look at that. And then it has these red inserts, and then it says ZL1 right there, Recaro. And then it goes all the way down, more leather, and then suede, and then the red inserts everywhere. Also comes with these beautiful red seat belts like the Hellcat does. Also has the Alcantara steering wheel with the flat bottom. Says ZL1 right here, Camaro right here, red stitching again, all over, red stitching, pretty awesome. And then it has these vents that kind of look like airplane vents, pretty cool. They definitely make it look like it's some sort of spaceship. And also more Alcantara with the red stitching all over. And then I believe there's a projector right there. And then this is the dash. I'm not too big of a fan of the dash because I feel like it's a bit old school, especially because Chevy likes to keep up on their technology and they like to be ahead. Well, this shows that that's not true. So let's turn it on. So let's go through the settings real quick. So you got your speedometer right here. You also have a digital speedometer. Let's see, if you go down, it tells you your miles, fuel range, oil life, tire pressure, timer, speed limit, and all that good stuff. So let's move on to the entertainment system. You got your GPS right here. You got your, oh, I think you could change the colors. I believe it has ambient lighting, but it's all like right here. You see that? It's blue right there, but you could change it. They're called the light strips. You got your phone, your sound, and I think that's your messages. So let's move on. It also comes with the 10-speed auto. Again, more Alcantara here. You got your different modes right here, so we could change it. Tour, sport, track, snow, and ice. Another cool thing is you could charge your phone back here. So this is my first time sitting in a ZL1 and sitting on these Recaro seats, and they're honestly beyond comfortable. Like, my Recaro seats in my Mustang, they're Recaros, but they're like overly sporty. I mean, they're like bucket seats. So these are like my Hellcat seats and my Mustang Recaro seats together. They're comfortable, beefy, and they're sporty. Shout out to Chevy because these seats are awesome and I feel so comfortable in them. And now we're gonna take it for a ride and see how quick this thing is and how comfortable it is. It's my first time driving a ZL1, so it's gonna be an experience for me. So let's hop in and take it to the GoPro. Let's get it.
Get these red seat belts on. Raced anyone with it yet?
Well, the Hellcat there at the meet.
How'd that go?
And the toy says, well, it was the first time running it. Like, I've never ran it before. Because it still had like 800 miles on it. It wasn't fully broken in.
Yeah. But they're not fast. My friend ran a ZL1, and the ZL1, like, he beat it by 8 cars. It was that bad. And it's just like, they're not ready to, like, unless you break them in, you know? The wine, it's not too quiet.
You can put it on race mode.
Are we in sport mode right now?
Yeah, but it also has a.
So we're gonna put it in race mode. So it doesn't shift on its own after you put it manual?
No, you have to go back like that.
Oh. See, my 10 speed in my Mustang shifts on its own.
Yeah,
once I downshift it to whatever, second, third, and then I just go, it'll just pretend like it's a, you know how a Hellcat just shifts on its own?
Yeah.
Same thing.
Nah, this one, if you switch it to manual or with the shifting pads, it'll go back to automatic if you do a full stop or if you switch it like this.
So I'll put it this way and then downshift and then throw it back?
Yeah.
Roll for you is what? Have you figured out yet? Like a 50 roll, right?
Yeah, 50.
And it has, these are good tires.
like it's hugging the road.
Yeah, it feels tight.
What's your favorite thing? What car did you have before this?
2SS.
Okay, and how, I mean, there's a huge difference, right?
Yeah. That's all.
So you've only raced the Hellcat, that's it? What else have you raced?
The Hellcat and the 2SS, but that one's modern.
How did you do against that?
Just as front end was ahead of me.
Man,
they warmed up their tires. It wasn't letting me line lock.
It was a dig?
Huh?
You didn't have a stop?
Oh, yeah, yeah, with the 2SS? Yeah.
Oh, okay. So we're halfway through the drive, and it is amazing, honestly. It drives so well, so comfortable. It doesn't even feel like you're in a sports car. I mean, the seats are beyond comfortable. It's hugging the road, and then when you step on it, you hear the supercharger whine, and you just go. And it just, the speedometer is just skipping, literally. 40, 45, 50 is just skipping, and it's a pretty quick car. But we're gonna try to do launch control, and we'll see how that's gonna work. This thing is nasty, man. Have you touched the exhaust? No. Stock? Dude, you should put Corsa exhaust. You know how nasty it'll sound?
I'm gonna get quick headers.
Bro. These cars love exhaust, man. So I just slap it.
Yeah, like that.
It sounds really good. I like it. So we're gonna try to do launch control now. Oh, I think you passed it. Spinning way too much.
I hate
what's it called, launch control. It's so bad. Like watch how much better it's gonna be without this launch control stuff. I hate it. I'm gonna rev it up to 1500, leave traction off, or actually leave it on and then go. So it's a little better, but it's obviously gonna need some tires. But off a roll, it is honestly amazing. It doesn't spin. We did a 40 roll, and usually people don't race anything under 40. It's usually 40, 50, 60, but off a 40, it is doing really good. All right, guys, so that's pretty much it on the ZL1. So I hope you guys enjoyed the little review, the drive, the launch mode, the launch control, all that good stuff I just did with the car. So if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a big thumbs up. If you're new to this channel, smash the subscribe button, turn your notification bell on to stay up to date with the videos and be part of the family. If you're not already following me on Instagram, make sure you go ahead and follow me at ToxicSRT. Also add me on Snapchat at ToxicSRT. But with that being said, shout out to ZL1 Savage. Make sure you guys go and follow him on Instagram. He has a dope ZL1, and thank you for letting me review it. But it's time to let you guys go. So have an awesome day, and make sure you guys stay positive. Peace out.